Yes, I was a stripper, and I am proud to say it. And I don't even know why people try to hide the fact. Oh, he got a hairstyle on set. Oh, bitch, please.
It's sticking out. That yeah.
Y'all need you is not going to try to play me today, Heidi. That damn B. Scott is a hot mess, honey.
Can't hardly wait to be through with you.
Wouldn't you agree?
Been different, divine. I am. You know it. Been different, divine.
Love Muffins, we have someone on the show today that you may not know, but you should. Soul artist Ndombi.
Hi. So thank you for coming on the show.
Thanks for having me. I'm so glad to be here.
Okay, so tell us, for my Love Muffins who may not know who you are, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, before I say that, can I just say that I'm such a fan of your show? I'm such a fan.
Thank you.
I'm so excited to be here. My sister's a fan too.
Hey, sister. Hey, what's your sister's name?
Shawnee.
Hey, Shawnee.
Anyway, okay.
Thank you. A little bit about yourself.
Okay, well, I'm from Dallas, Texas.
Dallas,
my name.
Texas.
Yes, okay. My name is Ndombi, as you just said. Dallas, Texas. And I started singing in church.
Okay.
My parents were, my father was a pastor, my mom a minister.
Okay.
And so my starts of music would be gospel and, you know, we didn't really get to listen to secular music growing up.
And boy, has that changed.
Yes, it has. It's changed yeah. But we listened to a lot of gospel and country and western, because country and western was my father's favorite. I decided to make a demo. And okay. In the process of doing that, I was around this community of creative kids. We were all doing art stuff. And so too, and that scene was Erica Badu.
Erica Badu, oh my goodness, I love Erica. How was that? You used to sing background vocals for her, correct?
I sure did, that was a great experience. It was a lot of fun times, a lot of creativity.
So who are your influences?
My first influence would have to be my parents. I would have to say them okay. first. And then also I have
are they singers too?
They're singers, they can really
sing. So they're singing ministers?
They're singing.
Singing.
Ministers. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, singing ministers, and then I would also have to say, I have to give kudos to the deacons and the missionaries at the church, because something about that sound that they used to do, I used to like to mimic all the sounds. So they make a sound, they go, then I go home and practice that.
What was it again? All right now. I want to go to your church.
At some point, somebody said, you know what, you should listen to Nina Simone. I said, who is that?
Oh, wow. Yes.
You didn't know who Nina Simone was? Oh, my gosh. She's one of my favorites. Yeah.
I didn't know.
The legendary Nina Simone.
Yes, the legendary. So.
And you did a song called Ode to Nina.
I did. I did a song in tribute to her. And after I found out who she was and her tone and her presence in music and how she would make it, it's like bittersweet.
And so since you brought it up, I would love for you to sing a little bit of Ode to Nina.
I'm not complaining, I'm just tired of your coming, your going, your leaving, your staying, yeah.
Wouldn't you agree?
That was so good. You did Nina good. Wow. Tell us about this new album. What's the name of it and what does it sound like?
Okay, this new album is called Pink Elephant.
Okay.
Pink Elephant?
Yeah.
Like the pink elephant in the room?
Yeah, that's the elephant in the room. Okay. It's a take on that anyway.
Okay.
It's a take on an elephant in the room. That, you know, and the phrase, as the phrase goes, it's people choose to ignore it.
I'm sitting here looking at you and I'm trying to ask you, I want to ask you a question. How do you get your afro so perfect? It's like perfectly round.
When I braid it up every night.
So you braid it up and take it out and pick it?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
I do the old.
Can I touch it? I hate when people do this to me, but.
Go ahead.
Wow.
Yeah.
I like it.
I do. Thank you. I use the Blue Magic grease.
Blue Magic.
Okay, Blue Magic.
Okay. Yeah, that's the trick. You put the Blue Magic in and the parts and then braid it up and then.
I expect my check, Blue Magic.
So the album's coming out. What's the first single?
The first single is Can't Hardly Wait.
I don't know why I keep
with you.
When you spend my money, shall I keep right on
with you?
At times it's funny, but I keep right on
with you.
They tell me run, leave, but I won't. I keep on.
I keep messing with you.
I can't hardly wait to be through with you. Hardly wait. Still I'm
messing with you.
I can't hardly wait to be through with you. Hardly wait. Still I'm
messing with you.
And what does Ndombe mean?
It means the most beautiful.
Oh, I like that name. Thank and you. It fits you. I love the eyes
thank
as well.
You.
Thank you so much for stopping
Thanks
by.
Thanks for having me. I so enjoyed
myself. Double kiss. Mwah. Mwah. So, Love Muffins, we are here with the fabulous NeNe Leakes from The Real Housewives of Atlanta. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you so much for having me.
You look fabulous today.
Didn't you know it? You thought I would come looking any other kind of way?
No, I didn't.
Oh, thank you
okay.
so much.
So before I have to ask you about what mm-hmm. happened this weekend. You did the Emmys. How
I
was
did
that?
The Emmys. It was a great honor. Mm-hmm. It really was. I was very happy and honored for Ryan Seacrest to call me and ask me to do the red carpet with E! Uh-huh. And watch the arrivals. You know, it was the 61st annual Emmy. Mm-hmm. And there's not a whole lot of, you know, African Americans there.
Right. So you represented.
I was very honored. Okay. I was very honored. And you know, it didn't matter if my dress was torn, if my hair was out of place. Mm-hmm. I was at the 61st annual Emmy Award. And so it wasn't very many brown girls.
Right. So getting back to the Real Housewives of Atlanta for
yes.
a second. I heard that you were actually the one that, you know, really put the whole show together in a way.
Yes. Well, I will tell you what happened was I had a friend mm-hmm. that said to me for weeks, I know the producers are the Real Housewives of Orange County and they're coming out here to do Atlanta. Okay. And I said, girl, stop playing. You know, she was one of those girls to mm-hmm. me that's always trying to act like she got a connection and don't really have one.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So she really had a connection this time. And she called me. She was like, girl, they want to talk to you. And I was like, seriously? So the lady came over and talked to me. And after the interview, and she asked me, tell me some other girls that you know. Mm-hmm. And I gave them Sheree Whitfield, Kim Zolciak, Deshaun Snow, and a girl by the name of Terry Ewing.
Okay.
And Terry Ewing couldn't work out her contract, and they went out and hired Lisa Wu Hartwell. Okay. I didn't know Lisa coming into the first season.
Okay. And so now, being that we're working on towards mm-hmm. the end of the second season, mm-hmm. How do you feel about the show?
I think the show's fantastic. We're number one.
Right. We're number one.
Yeah, we're brown girls.
Right, and you think it's definitely launched you into doing many mm-hmm. different things.
Yeah.
How do you feel like it has affected your image?
I don't feel like it's affected my image. You know, everybody has an opinion.
Yeah, because you're a mother and you're a wife and all that.
Yeah, so. I'm a mom right. and I'm a wife. And one thing about my husband and I's relationship is we've been together for a very long time. Mm-hmm. So we're very solid. So what the media has to say or anybody else have to say about criticizing our relationship, mm-hmm. it won't affect us at all because we've been together for years. Mm-hmm. So we're not like a couple who met in Hollywood and got married and then Hollywood media could tell you apart. Mm-hmm. They can't tell me and Greg apart. Mm-hmm. If Greg and I break up, it will be because we broke up. It won't
right.
have anything to
do with the show.
Yeah, not because of the show or not because of anything else, because my husband knows me very well and I know him. My two children, I have a teenager. Mm-hmm. He's a teenager, and he's not really thinking that much about this show. My son thinks that whenever his face appears on the camera, great, because some girl's going to want to talk to him. So that's all he's thinking about. He's 19.
Right.
My 10-year-old is just 10.
Right.
So he's just a little boy. But as far as anything else, it has been a blessing and a curse for me to be on a show like this. It's mm-hmm. helped me in so many ways mm-hmm. to be able to do things like being able to do the Emmys or being invited to so many right. different talk shows.
And you just did The Insider, right?
I just did The Insider. I mean, I hosted the Today Show in New York City with mm-hmm. Hoda Kotb and Kathy Lee Griffin. Mm-hmm. I've done.
Was
you know,
that fun? They are
that
so
was
crazy
very
to me.
Fun.
They are just off the chain.
They were very fun. They were mm-hmm. very welcoming, and I loved it.
Right.
I've been on Ellen DeGeneres. Oprah Winfrey asked me to do the O Magazine.
Ooh.
So I did the O Magazine, reality stars who have become a household name. So I did that along with Kim Kardashian and Kristen Cavallari mm-hmm. and a lot of other girls. These are my blessings.
Right.
The curse or the negative side mm-hmm. of it
right.
is that people are saying things about you that are not true, mm-hmm. or digging into your personal life where they don't need to go.
Speaking of which, were you ever a stripper? Because that was a rumor.
Yes, I wrote it.
Okay.
In the book that I was a stripper. I'm not okay. ashamed of that. Okay. And I don't see what the issue is, because everybody's out here taking stripper pole classes.
Right.
What is the problem? Yes, I was a stripper, and I am proud to say it, and I don't even know why people try to hide right. the fact. See.
And that is not how you met your husband.
That is not how I
okay.
met my husband.
That's a rumor, too.
That was, okay, that's okay. not how I wrote in the book about me being a stripper. I don't have anything negative about, you know, the stripper life or the stripper past.
Okay.
I was getting myself out of a situation that I was in. Mm-hmm. Instead of people really talking about the real issue at hand, which was I was in an abusive relationship with a man abusing me mm-hmm. regularly. And I couldn't find my way out of it. And I write about it in the book. I could not find how to get out of it. I was a single mom with a child. I needed to get out. I didn't have any money. I didn't have anywhere to go. And I didn't have anybody to fall back on. Like, my family, like my aunt who raised me was not in a financial situation,
yeah,
where she can really help me, you know. Mm-hmm. And so I had to do what I had to do, and stripping
and so the
is what
was
I did.
The answer at that
For
time.
Me, mm-hmm. it was the answer. Now, it's not the role that everybody would take, but I had long legs and luscious lips. Honey, I don't see why.
And ta-tas. Right.
Right. And I don't see why I couldn't mm-hmm. have done it. And I right. did it, and the men loved it, and my husband know about it. I'm very mm-hmm. open about it. I'm not telling women out here to take that road. Mm-hmm. I'm just saying that's what I had to do.
And I'm not ashamed of it.
No, and I had to come through. And the key is, I came through.
I saw an upcoming episode.
Right here. Oh, he got a hairstyle on set. Oh, bitch, please.
It's sticking out that way.
Yeah. You is not gonna try to play me today, honey. That damn B. Scott is a hot mess, honey. Honey, if y'all see a hair flying out, y'all better come over here and fix my hair. How they work the camera and work.
Somebody getting fucked.
Look, honey, they working the camera and working the damn hair, honey. Do I need a powder, honey? Okay, thank you. Make sure my damn nose ain't shining.
Okay, say it. Okay, now getting back to what we're talking about, in the episode, you and Candy got into it.
Yes.
It's coming up this week. So mm-hmm. what happened?
Well, you know what I really feel about me and Candy's mm-hmm. relationship is that we never had the opportunity to really get to know each other.
Right. So what actually happened that caused the fight?
Well, what caused the argument on camera was, yeah. Mm-hmm. Let me think back, honey, because that's been so many months ago. It had to do with Kim. Oh, mm-hmm. Of course,
okay.
Her and her wig right. in the picture again.
Kim and her wig. What you saying?
And her and her wig in the picture again.
You ain't right.
What actually happened mm-hmm. was I was trying to tell her that it was something about Kim not wanting me to be on the track mm-hmm. on the okay.
tardy for the party.
And I was telling her, I know what happened. During that whole little controversy about me saying something about tardy for the party, she said to me that she heard I had been talking about her to everybody. Mm-hmm. And that's what really escalated what we were talking about, take it to the next level. Mm-hmm. She says, I heard you've been talking about me to everybody. And I was mm-hmm. saying, who is everybody?
Right.
And she said, people in production. She was naming
different people
in mm-hmm. the production. Mm-hmm. And I was saying, are you kidding me? Because really, I'm sure they're going to cut and take their people in production names out. But what I'm thinking is the producers, if she was saying that the producers was telling her that I said things about her, mm-hmm. the producers are trying to make a show.
Right.
Are you kidding me? Yeah.
Right.
Are you actually trying to tell me that the producers have told you something about me? They need a show here.
Right.
And don't even try to take it that far.
Right.
Like, it's not that serious. I don't talk about you because guess what, Candy? I don't know you. And second of all, if I have anything to say about you, I'll tell you to your face. Now, that's just how bold I am.
Right.
Like, seriously.
That's being real.
If
that's
I talked
show.
About you, yeah. I'd tell, because I'd already mm-hmm. told her prior to that I talked about her before.
Right.
I told her one day at a lunch, so I said some things about you on camera, you know, didn't really mean no harm, but I'm just saying, mm-hmm. I'm just telling
right.
you, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like,
so how does that work? I don't get it. Like, you know, sometimes you say, you know, you said some things on the camera, but you didn't really didn't mean harm. So would you say some hurtful things, or and then you
no.
trying to brace her for him, or what? You,
I mean, no, I wasn't trying to brace her for him. You know, I'm a more of a jokingly
okay.
kind of person.
So
I may say something and it'd be jokingly.
Joking,
and other
jokingly
people may,
harsh.
Yeah, some okay. other people may take it harsh. So I was just trying to let her know that, you know, whatever it was that I was saying, they've already played it anyway. It was me and Dwight at the mm-hmm. fabric store, and we would say, fiance, goodbye. But, you know, and we were doing, right. I said something like, Candy, she did a record a long time ago, something like mm-hmm. that. Anyway, to me, it wasn't harsh.
Mm-hmm.
So I was just telling her, you know, in case she thought it may have been harsh or if it came off harsh, because you have to understand too, we're on a reality show. So I can say something and I could be looking down at my shoe and then I might look up at the spot on the wall and that's what they'll cut and clip to. Right. Like she said it and then look, her head turns and she went that way, you know, and really, right.
So that like in some respects that, you know, the moments we see may or may not be as real as we see it, if that makes sense.
Well, the Real Housewives, we're very real.
Real, but
I'm just prepared. I'm just, they do. They do cut. And it could be, like I said, you could have been sitting here looking like I'm listening to you talk. Mm-hmm. And then they cut that scene where you were staring at me just
to make it more dramatic.
Yes.
Right, okay.
That's all I'm saying. And then people start commenting on the blogs and be like, did you see that look she gave, honey? Mm-hmm. And right. You could have been like, girl, I was sitting up here looking at the spot on the wall, and they cut that and put that in. But, you know, nevertheless, reality TV can take you to levels, different right. levels, and reality TV is very popular now.
Exactly.
Celebrities have them. Exactly. You know, regular folks have them. You know, it's you got to love it. And
so I'm going to play the game with you that I played with two other.
Yes, I knew I needed some. Try to play me like a sucker.
It's the long night runway roar. Will the judges give me a score? Don't stop that bitch, give me some more. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's the long night runway roar. Will the judges give me a score? Don't stop now, bitch, give me some more. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4.
I wish you all the best.
Thank you so much. And you can wrap up my interview. This album's gonna wrap up our interview.
Ow!
See, love my
friends. Okay, I'm at an age, I would say, now in my life where I'm not interested in impressing you. Right. I don't even give a shit.
Yeah, baby, don't be late. I'll meet you at the place. I've been waiting for this day. It's a weekend, let's celebrate.